Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and today we're going to talk about 70-461, which is querying Microsoft SQL Server 2012, and it's one of the SQL MCSA exams. And I'm here with Dandy Nguyen, who's a technical product marketing manager. Now, Dandy, you have a huge background in SQL, know tons of stuff. Tell us how you got here and a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, first of all, thanks for having me, and thanks for the compliment on the resume. Actually, it's all because of Microsoft certification that I'm sitting here today and actually was able to build my career on SQL Server for the longest time. So started working with databases when I was 16.
Wow.
Built my first application back then. And actually, the great thing about a product like SQL Server, like a database product, mm-hmm. is you can really continue to build on top of your existing knowledge. So at some point in time, started doing some work with Microsoft Learning into the courseware curriculum, actually, courseware development, lab development, and so on. And 2008, landed a job at Microsoft and continue to work and enhance my SQL Server knowledge, went into the master certification and so on, and I'm now a technical product manager for SQL Server. So
yeah, so now this certification starts off with querying SQL, and it's new for us to have an entire exam on querying. So can you tell us a little bit about that, and how does querying really fit into the bigger SQL world?
That's a great question, right? I mean, if you look at it, and you're right in saying in the past we did not have a mm-hmm. querying exam, and to me, in my opinion, on what I see in the industry and projects that I work on is frequently I would end up with people that don't have enough experience to write an optimized querying code or write an optimized syntax or struggle finding the most accurate syntax to actually accomplish the task. I've been seeing projects where people had like 5 pages of code, and you look at it and go like, wait, I can write this in 5 lines of code to do exactly the same and not having to have that process run 30 minutes, but have it done in less than a minute.
Yeah.
So I'm actually quite excited about the fact that we introduced that querying exam for SQL. Because it's so important, especially if you think about monitoring, you think about using dynamic management views, which actually sure. allows you to find out how is my database performing. If you go into a DBA role or just writing optimized code that a database developer, it actually is quite crucial. So I'm very happy with the fact that we're testing on that. Mm-hmm. And you also see that as an industry requirement,
yeah.
right, where people need to write optimized code.
Well, that's interesting to me because as a non-SQL guy, to me, querying is just querying. I didn't really realize, like your example of a big bit of code versus a little bit of code, to me, it was all just querying.
Yeah, and there's definitely, I mean, the great thing about SQL as the language, yeah. structured query language, what is different dialects and varieties on different platforms mm-hmm. is, yeah, you have this commonality across and people will know how to write a join or they know how to use certain functions, but
sure.
a lot of times they're not aware of the function specifically for SQL Server to accomplish a task. Like I started my database career doing some Oracle development as well, and mm-hmm. so when I took my first SQL Server certification exam, I was actually struggling with some of that syntax because I did not really know what the exact syntax was for SQL Server.
Mm-hmm.
And later on in my career, it actually became crucial knowing the right syntax just to get that performance you want to have when you're developing database solutions.
Yeah, I assume SQL is SQL. Who knew?
It's like English and English, right? And,
yeah, I guess.
And sometimes if you're not really, really experienced in English or it's not your native language,
yep.
you need to think about things and it really comes down to the experience
sure.
and setting a difference in qualifications to that perspective.
So another big topic that is huge to SQL is tables. So explain why tables are so important.
Well, tables are the core storage components of your data,
yeah.
right? So everything in a relational database sits in a table. Doing a great table definition is so much more than going to a graphical user interface or writing a create table statement with mm-hmm. all of its possible options. It's about making sure you know how to set database constraints, like what is accepted within the columns,
okay.
What is accepted within the database, or even the choice of the data type is becoming very important as well. Like what kind of data are you going to store in each of those, and how are you going to get the data out of that? So not only, I mean, creating the tables is a core component of your database.
Sure.
So of course you need to know on how that works. Now, there's some things in administration that you're not going to need for this querying exam because you need to know the basic syntax, basically, and how to query it and how to update and delete, sort of the basic data manipulation language queries mm-hmm. that you're going to be writing. But it's definitely an important factor in a querying exam and building out that foundation for your future qualifications.
Okay. So let's wrap up with some tips you might have. If you had to give somebody like one thing to do to pass 461, what should they focus on?
Oh, so what I typically do, and I'm going to give you a little secret on how I prepare for
my certification
exams, right? So I'm not even sure if I'm a little embarrassed to tell, but when I took my first SQL exam, I actually failed the exam at first. Mm-hmm. And so what I've done is like, hey, what did I do wrong here? And the thing that I did wrong was by not focusing on the things that I typically don't use.
Okay.
Like XML, for example, and understanding the XML query language and how that works in SQL Server. If you're not familiar with that, focus on the areas that you're not familiar with.
Yeah.
And even more, is one of the things that I think is probably the key to focus on is what is new in a specific version of SQL Server? Because there seems to be this trend like, well, it's a new feature. And not because we want to test on it because it's a new feature, but the new feature actually is a significant improvement. Mm-hmm. That you're going to need on your day-to-day job. So you might want to look on, hey, what is different and what's the best potential solution if you're implementing one of those result sets or one of those questions pops up and you look like, yeah, this is the most plausible answer because this is not only one of the newer features, but it's also something that does make sense from a performance perspective.
Well, and that's very similar to my recommendation whenever I tell people, you know, the best thing you can do to study is go look at those objectives right above us on this web page and look at them. Make sure you know how to do them. Run through them with a practice lab.
And hands-on experience is probably one of the things as well. It's like there's a lot of resources that we have available, hands-on labs, training guides, and so on. Have a look at those and get experience.
Yep.
You cannot just go like, oh, wake up and say like, hey, I'm going to take an exam today.
Yeah. Well, thanks so much for being here, Dandy. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
So we've been talking about 70461 querying Microsoft SQL Server 2012, and it's one of your MCSA SQL Server exams. So go out and get certified.
Good luck.